Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate, Siege of Dragonspear Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, now heading down into, I'm assuming, the basement again. We came up from below the basement, and now we're going down into the basement. Well, at least we're heading that way. Duncan's awaiting for us there. Says he has her, has Kaelor pinned down, we hear.
Yes.
Berserk state has ended. Okay, some more soldiers here from the coalition.
Yes.
To the other side of that gate. Right. We were here. There's the lift down. The storage room. Where we poisoned their water. We didn't get past this gate. Never got that far. As soon as he poisoned the water, people poured out of here. Started going after her. We didn't get a chance to poison the food. Gotten this far.
I need a swig of some strong dwarven.
Order is what matters.
I've read that. You know, let's head this thing here. A massive pile of rubble fills the passageway, preventing anyone from exploring outer portions of Dragonspear Castle's basement. There's Daros coming up. Same here.
Yes.
Daros looking for us. Hail.
Bloody hell's Heffernan.
What is it now?
Wait. You're not Heffernan. Who are you?
You're a ghost. Oh, Daros! That's Daros Dragonspear. Right? That's his name? Right, yeah, builder of this castle. Hesitant to say this because they often don't know they're ghosts and sometimes they get angered if you start calling them that. Who are you?
I've no love for the fell-dirking beast. The swine bound me here.
What?
In life, I was Daros Dragonspear, builder of this castle.
Oh.
I lingered here many years, watching my last home change hands and fall to ruin.
Okay, so he knows that he's a ghost, so that would have been fine to say that, I'm guessing. Have you learned anything of Heffernan's plans? Tell me what you know, I beseech you.
He plays the pious, kind-hearted priest, but he's trying to open a gate to the nine hells, the snake. I first saw Heffernan when he came down here with that Asimar, what's her name? Kayla. You know what an Asimar is?
Yes.
Celestial-blooded, you could say.
Mm-hmm.
They needed divine blood to open the gate, but Kayla's wasn't strong enough to do the job.
Right. Opening a gate to the Nine Hells. I think we knew that. That's what Kaelor wants to do. It explains why we found the Nine Hells book in this room. Okay, so they needed divine blood to open the gate, but Kaelor's wasn't strong enough to do the job. Oh, could be why they wanted my blood. The Child of Baal. Yeah. Well, I'd rather he tell me. Timora smiled upon us then. The last thing the Sword Coast needs is the Hells invading again. What happened next?
Heffernan got madder than a hornet in a helmet. He stormed off with Kaelor trailing after him. When he came back, I saw him use that altar there to speak with some dark creature. The fiend spotted me. Heffernan bound me right quick. I've been trapped ever since.
Is there a way I can set you free?
Rub those marks on the floor out and you'll break the spell binding me. Lend a hand. Or a boot. Get me out of this.
It is done. Go free, spirit.
Aye. I'm free.
Oh.
But the fugue pulls on my soul. I hear the call of my old friend Halitathlea.
Oh.
Thank you for bringing us back together.
The dragon. Okay, I thought I had to rub this first.
Listen now. In the center of the castle's main hall floor mosaic is a loose stone. If it's not been discovered, you should find something of worth beneath it.
Main hall floor mosaic. Okay, is that this then? I thought I was supposed to be rubbing this, so maybe this is a loose stone. Main hall floor mosaic. Unless he means up above.
Axe high, friend. When you find Heffernan, give him a good kick in the nether regions for Deros Dragonspear.
Sounds like a good time to me. I put the spirit of Deros Dragonspear to rest. I found the ghost of Deros Dragonspear and set him free. He's gone to the fugue playing to meet the spirit of his dragon friend Helitathlir. I thought we had to go interact with this thing to set him free. The interior of this crate is coated with a gooey substance mystically imbued with luminescence that illuminates the area. Oh, this is... okay. See, I thought this was the basement. Alright.
You want me?
Just in case it's trapped as well.
Right.
A den of stinking evil. Actually, this evil is not as smelly as it usually is.
Ooh.
We come for you anyway. Well scrubbed, evil.
Deros is full plate plus one. I thought she was going to be weighed down. This heavy steel breastplate bears the image of a soaring copper dragon on the front. The lightness of the breastplate and the fine detail on the dragon's image suggest dwarven craftsmanship. Dwarven craftsmanship is always the best. Oh, fire resistance plus 40. So this way, if Minsk wears this, then he can get here plus 80 after all fire resistance. Zay versus breath plus 2. We're going to be fighting a dragon, aren't we? Armor class 0. Negative 4 versus slashing, negative 3 piercing, and missile. That's 30 pounds. Not usable by... I don't see Ranger in this list. So this is armor class 0. So this shouldn't affect his armor class. This is 4 slashing, 3 piercing and missile. 4 slashing, 3 piercing and missile. Yeah, same. Okay. And then... magic fire 40 and fire 80. Nice. You'll be tanking a dragon, Minsk. Hope you enjoy it. We just found that full plate, and now we're graduated to the next thing. Okay, so I've seen these rooms, and I've seen this room.
Sweetheart? Yes, dear.
What's in here? Anything? Ah, 'tis trapped. You picked it from there. And disarmed it from there. Magical bullets. Don't really need them. Got so many of them now. Well, let me just see what they are. Either the bullets plus 2. Yep. Plus 1. Bullet of ice plus 1. Bullet plus 3. Alright, well... I can take that. 1d4 plus 1 and then 1d6 cold damage. Well, when we get so many fire things, I'm thinking fire might do well against it. So maybe have ice. And then what do you have? Bullet of electricity. Right. I have them. electricity. And then you have all this stuff, so might not do too well. Plus, it's only 2 fire damage. So, bullet plus 3. You can carry that. Put that there. Healer?
Mm-hmm. What? Fine.
Still, we wait.
You are more than welcome in my sight.
We're more than mercenaries.
Okay.
You want Boo?
Don't have anything to say.
What?
Yes.
It's nearly over.
Duncan.
Kalar retreated into this vault. There's no way out. Our mage reports a strange magical aura behind the door. We've got to be careful. Are you ready for the final battle?
What sort of magical aura? Flaming Fist Mage says, I detect powerful alteration magic tinged with evil. Illusion magic is in play as well. We'd best be cautious in penetrating this vault.
What do you say then? Are you ready for this final battle?
I need more time to prepare. I'll return when I'm ready.
Hurry. The longer she's able to prepare for us, the harder the battle will be.
Indeed. Well, I want to see what's in here first. It's really the only reason I'm delaying. Okay. Oh. The smell of incense hangs heavy in the air, almost but not quite covering the odor of rotting meat that lingers around this altar. This wooden table is cluttered with magical paraphernalia from a variety of disciplines, mystical, divine, and infernal. Alright.
Your need? Whatever you like.
Oh, there's more back here, another room behind these curtains. Or area. Both trapped. Got a lot of experience for that. I mean, compared to normal. Okay, scroll of spell immunity, lower resistance, and spell shield. Shoved haphazardly at a corner of the chamber, this pen for some sort of animal, a cat or a small dog, or perhaps something less mundane, sits empty and rusting. Huh. What was in there? Ooh! On magical entrapments. I got goodies! Look at these first. This crown, mage robe. Very interesting. Okay, so this I can learn. This is level 5. Spell shield. When this spell is cast, the wizard is protected from the next magical attack against her. The spells that protects the wizard... The spells that this protects the wizard from are Spell Thrust, Secret Word, Breach, Lower Resistance, Pierce Magic, Ruby Ray, Kelvin's Warding Whip, Pierce Shield, and Spell Strike. If one of these spells is cast at the wizard, the spell activates and absorbs the attack. However, this only works once, as this spell is consumed in the process. Otherwise, it will last for the duration. Well... I could write the magic, but... Spell immunity, level 5 as well. I'm tempted to just use it as a scroll, because otherwise we have to rest, right? Casting this spell grants the wizard protection from one spell school of her choice. After the spell is cast, the wizard must choose the school she wishes to be protected from. All spells of this school will not be able to harm or aid the caster for the duration of this spell. This includes all spells from this school, including any priest spells that might benefit the caster. And lower resistance, I guess we have that one. Lowers the magic resistance by 10% plus 1% per level of the caster. There is no saving throw, and magic resistance, if any, does not affect the spell. That is interesting. Spell immunity only lasts for one round per level. On what level? 11. So 11 rounds, it's all. I want to learn the spell, but I want to be protected by the spell for this...
Yes?
...encounter coming up. So you know what? I'll learn spell immunity. And I'll keep the other... That's awfully... I mean, out of all these, I think I've seen Secret Word and Breach. And Lower Resistance, obviously. Well, let's learn... Let's learn Spell Immunity and use Spell Shield as a... What do you call it? As a thing, a scroll. Okay, and then... This stuff. Exciting. On to the book. Yeah. Put that. Wait. Put that in here. Oh, I need to identify the stuff. Both of them. Which means I do need to rest. Magical entrapments. Or on magical entrapments. Many spells exist which can tear a subject's spirit from its body or its remains. Magic Jar is one such spell, an incantation which traps a creature's spirit in an object until it can inhabit a new host. Certain magic items can be crafted to contain a soul, some of them enchanted so the holder of the container, be it a jar, a casket, a locket, or some other enclosed object, has power over the soul within. A spirit so trapped has no choice but to obey its captor until the item breaks or is otherwise released. Okay, so I think that's what happened to Halatathlier. As far as this is hinting that we're going to encounter this again, probably now, as soon as we go through there. Magic Jar. Traps a creature's spirit in an object until it can inhabit a new host. So we can find the jar. There might be something in there that we cannot defeat until we break the jar. Or, if we break the jar, we'll release the spirit, so it won't have to obey Kalor or Heffernan. Well, I want to identify this stuff. I gain experience for what? For reading that? Or opening, I guess opening that?
Yes. Right.
Okay, there's another area back here with a bed. Nothing. Alright. Maybe that thing is held by the spirit jar. It's a small thing, though. The dark liquid filling this black cauldron bubbles and burps in response.
Perhaps this group needs not quite as much help as I thought.
In response to the heat of the flames licking the pot. We need your help, Tiny here.
Sword first!
Alright, I want to identify this stuff. You guys are just gonna have to hang out. I know, it's kind of ridiculous. Alright. I want to know what this stuff does. Robe of Netheril. In the days of Netheril, the sorcerer Elemen Vale was so powerful that he could make and unmake the world around him as he saw fit, or so history claims. Legends and rumors surrounding the source of his power have passed their way across the centuries, but all stories share one vital fact, that in the peak of his power, Elemen's magic proved too powerful for him to control, and he lost his entire family. He created this robe, so the stories claim, from the tears of Mistral, to stanch his power and protect him from its influence. When he became sick in later years, Elemen refused to remove the garment in order to let the priests work their magic on him. "I have had enough of this world of magic," he said. "Let me die an ordinary man." And so he did. Magic resistance plus 50%. Disables spellcasting. Of course, it's only can be worn by a spellcaster. Right? Yeah, can't thief can't use shaman, yeah. Putting that in there in case I really don't need my spells anymore. Crown of Lies. This glittering golden crown looks impressive. Yes, it does. But its substance is base fool's gold, and the gems set around it are bits of colored glass. Placing the crown on one's head allows the wearer to prepare extra spells, but fills the head with false knowledge. Can memorize two extra third-level spells, one extra fourth-level spell, and one extra fifth-level wizard spell. Lore is minus 30. Interesting. Well. Put that in there.
Trouble?
Oh yeah.
Yes.
Weren't there three people here before? Can't talk to them.
We're more than mercenaries.
What do you say then? Are you ready for this final battle?
Hold on.
Hurry. The longer she's able to prepare for us, the harder the battle will be.
Stop talking so we're not in dialogue mode. Okay.
What do you say then? Are you ready for this final battle?
I don't know if I want to lead the battle. Ready? No, but it needs to happen regardless.
Well said. Open the door, soldiers. The Shining Lady's crusade ends now.
We haven't prepared anything.
And so we reach the end of a long, long journey. If you only knew the sacrifices I made to bring us to this point. All of them worthwhile.
Well, we should have buffed up. I thought of that right after we started going through the doors. Our mage detected illusion magic. Who else is here? Don't expect me to believe you're alone.
Change is upon us. Great and righteous change. You've come to face me, so do so. Now is our time.
Oh my god. Pause. Pause.
Fernan, you've caught me in your spell as well. I can't move!
Oh.
Have I now? How distressing for you. You'll just have to stand and watch as my plan reaches fruition.
Your plan? What do you mean? Heffernan, what are you doing?
He hit me? For like, what? What am I at? 53? Something? Can't tell.
You'll find out soon enough, my puppet. Once the devils begin their march into this world, bleed, Bosspawn.
Oh.
Bleed for my master.
He's taken my divine blood.
Gods help us all. They've opened the portal to the Nine Hells. Out! Everyone get out and get the vault door locked now!
Mercenary says, sir, what about...
Leave them! There's no time. We have to secure the vault immediately. Devils could flood this place any second.
Oh, they're gonna lock us in. That's nice of them.
Heffernan, what have you done? I will not let him corrupt our work by bringing forth an army of fiends! Crusaders, with me!
Oh. Kalar has escaped into the Nine Hells. Important events? Dragonspear Castle is secure, but Kalar is gone. She disappeared after Heffernan into a portal to Avernus. Some sort of plan she had has gone horribly wrong. I don't know what awaits me in hell, but it can't be good. I must use the portal to enter Avernus. I have no choice but to venture into Avernus and find a way to seal the portal between planes. Yeah, nothing in hell would ever be good. Wow. No quests. The Hooded Man.
I saw it first.
Who's that? Who's there?
Basil, Archduke of Maladomini, the Fallen One. Open the damn door.
Who is it I have the honor of addressing? I'm afraid I don't recognize your voice.
Huh. I'm even more offended. You'll recognize my face, you pompous jackass. It'll be the last thing you see before you die.
Corporal Duncan summoned the commanders when the portal opened. We have to keep the vault locked for now. Devils could easily overwhelm the castle otherwise. I'm sure you understand.
The portal? It's closed. You can let us out now.
My mages tell me the portal is open. And for as long as that remains the case, these doors are staying closed. You must find a way to seal this rift between planes. The fate of Toril is in your hands. May the gods smile upon you.
The whole plan is now clear to me. This whole hideous plan has become clear. Kalar never wanted me dead. Those assassins in the Ducal Palace used sleep poison because they were to steal my blood. Kalar needed divine blood to open a portal to Avernus in the Nine Hells to rescue the spirits of the Dragonspear Wars. Her right-hand man, Heffernan, has his own agenda, though. Now I must stop them both and find a way to seal this portal before there's a third Dragonspear War.
Hey there. Whatever you like.
Warded. Oh, wait! There's an imp.
Yes?
If you wait too long, they start coming through.
Another try, I shall hear.
Oh! A lemur. Wow. And a black abishai. Oh my god.
Take it like a champ.
Oh, they knocked him down.
Nature's servant awaits.
Thy called. Yes.
Attacking Minsk. Using command on Minsk.
By demand.
What is it?
Oh, would fireball even work?
Want me?
Yes, oh omnipresent authority figure.
Get up, Minsk. Oh, we killed the lemur. Uninjured, yeah. Fire's not gonna do much.
Freedom or death, fall down now.
Alright, let's... Oh, he's poisoned.
Nature's servant awaits.
You want more?
Yes, oh omnipresent authority figure.
Oh, I'm only missing one point. Never mind. Jahira saying, these attacks are just the beginning. We can't just stand here. We must act or we will be slain. That's a green abishai. Alright.
What?
Well, if we can get time, we can just... Let me just get rid of these.
This is the end for you.
Avernus sends its regards. Critical miss from Jahira. Alright, maybe we should just go through.
Let's talk more fight!
Avernus, the first pit of the Nine Hells assaults your senses. The stench of brimstone and curdled milk fills your nostrils, coating your tongue and throat in a nausea-inducing film. The bitter moans of the damned envelop you, pressing in from all sides, smothering. As your watering eyes grow accustomed to the dim lava light of the pit, you begin to feel the oppressive majesty of the blasted waste around you. In pursuing the Shining Lady, you have been brought to the darkest place imaginable, and the pursuit is not yet over. Crusader corpses litter the ground around you, but of Kayla herself, there is no sign.